This is a supersaturated solution of copper sulfate. It doesn't look too special, but watch what happens when I scratch the bottom of the beaker with a glass stir rod. Tiny crystals start to appear, seemingly out of nowhere, and continue to grow rapidly. So what just happened? An undisturbed supersaturated solution is stuck in a metastable state. The copper sulfate was dissolved into the solution at a high temperature and then was allowed to cool slowly and undisturbed. It was able to return to room temperature without crystallizing, so more ions are dissolved in the solvent than can stay in solution. While it's thermodynamically favorable for the copper sulfate to crystallize out of the solution, the copper and sulfate ions became trapped by a nucleation barrier, preventing crystal formation. Recrystallization sometimes gets stuck at this barrier if the beaker is really clean and smooth, so the solute doesn't have many contaminants or microscopic edges to use as nucleation points. Instead of using the glass stir bar, I could have just thrown a small copper sulfate crystal into the solution. It would function as a seed crystal, being the first nucleation point for more crystals to grow from there, but I feel like just the act of scratching the bottom is way more interesting. It's particularly interesting because the reason for why scratching the bottom of the beaker causes it to finally recrystallize isn't perfectly understood. One explanation is that tiny vibrations on the glass could be providing a little kick of kinetic energy, allowing the solution to overcome the nucleation barrier required for the phase transition to continue. Another possibility is that scratching creates microscopic glass particles that have a low surface energy, which in turn decreases the nucleation energy required for the phase transition, acting kind of like a catalyst. The inherent thermal motion of the ions can now overcome the reduced nucleation barrier, pushing the transition forward to allow nucleation and crystal growth. Either way, I think it's just really fun to see what looks like a stable solution undergo such a radical change just from a little stir. Thank you so much for watching.